So the MacBook Pro line is completely updated now with Apple Silicon chipsets inside them. However, what is the right MacBook Pro for you? Well, today I'm going to be doing a comparison of the M1 Pro, and also the M1 Max, and also the 13-inch, 14-inch, and 16-inch MacBook Pros, and working out for you what is the right MacBook for your needs. Hi, it's Matt here. So that's right, today I want to do a comparison of these three MacBook Pros that you see in front of me, what Apple offer right now. Also, I want to compare the kind of different sort of chipsets that are out there to help you match the kind of RAM, the storage, and everything else what is right for your needs with these MacBook Pros. So let's get started with what three models we have available. So first of all, we actually have the standard M1 13-inch MacBook Pro, and the 13-inch MacBook Pro comes with basically two options that you can pick from for kind of performance wise. So you can pick a M1 MacBook Pro with either 8 GB or 32 GB of RAM, but you do have lots of options of storage, as you can see here on Apple's website. So depending on how much storage you need, you can pick on that. Now, I will talk a little bit more further about basically the specs and reasons why to pick this 13-inch MacBook Pro a little bit later on in the video. But let's move on to the 14-inch MacBook Pro and what kind of options you can pick for that in kind of specs wise. So with this model right here, you can actually pick yourself either an M1 Pro or M1 Max chipset. Now, looking on Apple's website, there are loads of different choices that you can pick from. You can pick an M1 Pro with 8 cores and a 14-core GPU, all the way up to an M1 Max, and that comes with a 10-core CPU and also a 32-core GPU, and you can pick that with 64 GB of RAM. And with that M1 Pro, the baseline, you can choose it from 16 GB of RAM. There are loads of options where basically the GPU cores go up from 14 cores to 16 cores to 32 cores, and the same with the CPU, it goes from 8 cores to 10 cores. And obviously the M1 Max is a far more powerful chipset with some extra features inside it, so the ability to handle more RAM. Also, the memory bandwidth is 4,000 megabits compared to the standard 2,000 megabits on an M1 Pro. Also, you get sort of, for example, two video decoders where you only get one on the M1 Pro. The same here with the 16-inch MacBook Pro. It's a very, very similar lineup. The only difference is you can't pick that M1 Pro with that 14-core GPU and 8-core CPU. You can only pick the option of a 10-core CPU and a 16-core GPU inside it, and go all the way up to the M1 Max with that 64 GB of RAM, 32-core GPU and 10-core CPU. And with this option as well, you can choose between 16 GB all the way up to that 64 GB of RAM inside them. For storage for both of these devices, you can pick anything from 512 GB all the way up to 8 TB on both of these models. So that's with the specky bits and pieces out of the way for you kind of techie guys out there. But the main reason why you're probably here, guys, is probably wondering, well, with all those techie specs and things like this, which MacBook is right for me? Well, it depends on your kind of usage. So I'm going to give you a couple of scenarios out there. So first of all, if you are somebody who's maybe going off to university, off to college or in school, and let's say you're not really doing something that is going to be kind of technical related, IT related, that famous old word, information technology, IT related, then I would say the 13-inch MacBook Pro is going to be absolutely perfect for your needs. With this MacBook Pro, you can run things like the Office Suite, and in fact, I've actually made a video about this on my channel showing how well the Office Suite works on this. So this is the likes of Word, PowerPoint, Excel, you know, the likes of Chrome, for example, if you use that as your kind of web browser out there, even Safari as well. You can open up, say, about 30 tabs at one go, and also have the likes of Word, PowerPoint, let's say even Outlook open at the same time, and it will be absolutely fine, even on a MacBook Pro with just 8 GB of RAM. However, if you're going to be doing something a little bit more intense than that, let's say you're bringing in lots of pictures into your essays and things like this, then maybe 16 gigabytes of RAM might be a better option. But that M1 chipset inside this MacBook Pro is super powerful. And I've said this to a lot of guys out there recently. What you've got to remember with this M1 chipset inside it, the actual performance of this is actually more powerful than the highest spec last generation 16-inch MacBook Pro that we had out there, what cost basically about 3 times the amount of the baseline 13-inch MacBook Pro that you have right here. It is really, really amazing. So don't think that you actually need to get a high amount of RAM or you need to buy these two machines that you see right here. This one here is more than perfect for your needs. Now, something else that I would also comment about this MacBook Pro in its design, it is, as it were, the last generation design. And there's nothing actually wrong with that. It's still a great machine. You get the likes of, say, the touch bar, what's now been removed on the newer MacBook Pros that you see right here. Also, at the same time as well, you only get 2 USB-C ports on the side. But to be deadly honest, if you're a person who's just writing essays, maybe sticking in that odd external hard drive with your documents and things like this, this is going to be absolutely fine. You're not going to be sticking lots of different bits and pieces into this MacBook Pro. And if you did, you can buy dongles out there. And I put some of those ideas and dongles in my description below. So do check them out if you did actually want to get some dongles for your 13-inch MacBook Pro. So this is what I would say this model is definitely for. It's for those type of users. Now, don't get me wrong, if you do take videos on, say, your iPhone, let's say you've got yourself an iPhone 13, 12 or something like this, and you wanted to do a little bit of editing on it, say you wanted to use iMovie, or let's say you even installed Photoshop onto this 13-inch MacBook Pro, it will be able to handle it, and it will be absolutely fine. A lot of people out there before these two MacBook Pros actually ditched their 16-inch highest Intel MacBook Pro that was out there for this model because the power inside it is so incredible and it's been optimized for so many different apps, and many apps in the future will be optimized for these MacBook Pros with the Apple Silicon inside it. So yeah, definitely recommend looking into this 13-inch MacBook Pro if you're one of those type of users, or I'd even say, even if you're a person who's just at home, who just wants a MacBook around the house to do some sort of FaceTime calls, Zoom calls, Team calls, or anything like that, this is perfect for you to doing any of that kind of browsing. And the great thing is as well, with this MacBook Pro, it is most likely, at the time of making this video, this is the end of 2021, this MacBook Pro will probably get updates for at least, say, the next 5 to 6 years. So it is a great time to buy it, and there are lots and lots of deals out there for this MacBook Pro. So let's move on then to the 14-inch MacBook Pro and why you may consider getting this model here. Now, the 14-inch MacBook Pro is of the next generation. It's the newest design MacBook Pro. And to be honest, it's absolutely incredible and jam-packed with lots of features and enhancements over the 13-inch MacBook Pro that we have right here. Like I say again, there's nothing wrong with the 13-inch MacBook Pro, and it's right for probably most people's needs out there. So I'm going to say this is probably going to be the most popular MacBook Pro out there. But the next one here, this 14-inch one, does give you a slightly larger screen. Instead of the 13-inch that we have here, it is a 14-inch MacBook Pro. The other great thing, what you get with this, you get the mini LED display. This is a standard kind of LED in this. This is mini LED, so it's an improved kind of technology, what does help save on battery life inside the likes of this MacBook Pro here. But the great thing I love about that display is also it's that it's got an adaptive refresh rate on it. What this basically means is that the refresh rate of it, this basically means the screen refreshes itself a certain amount of times per second. And this is adaptive. So it goes from anything from 10 times per second all the way up to 120 times per second, or 10 hertz to 120 hertz. And this is absolutely amazing to have this inside this MacBook. So for example, if you're browsing on the web, for example, and as you're flicking around, and then let's say you stay still on an article, it will go right down that adaptive screen down to 10 hertz, but the second you start scrolling, it will go back up. It saves a lot on battery life. Also, as you may have probably noticed, compared to this 13-inch MacBook Pro, this screen is a lot brighter than what you get with this one here. Something else what you also get with this MacBook Pro is a great battery life. And I forgot to mention, on the 13-inch MacBook Pro, you also get a great battery life. Apple has claimed up to 20 hours on this MacBook Pro, whereas this one here, they've claimed up to 17 hours. And recently, I did a battery drain test, and you'll actually see on that battery drain test, check it out on my channel, that actually it was almost neck and neck. It was basically about 10 minutes apart on my drain test, where basically that this MacBook Pro, the 14-inch one, drained its battery before the 13-inch MacBook Pro. Really, they're almost neck and neck. You're not going to basically get an extra, say, double the amount of time, 10 hours on this MacBook Pro compared to this one. They are very, very similar in their kind of battery life. Now, other features why I would pick this MacBook Pro here, the 14-inch one, is you do get some additional ports and bits and pieces inside it. So you do actually get that Thunderbolt ports on the side, whereas you only get two on this MacBook Pro, you actually get three of them. So there's two on this side and there is one on this side. An additional what's also on this side is a HDMI 2.0 port. So this allows you to plug this into another monitor, and you can also use the USB-C ports on either side and then plug in an additional monitor if you wanted to do that as well and do it that way. Also, there's an SD card slot on this MacBook Pro, and also at the same time as well, there is that brand new MagSafe connection, or the MagSafe connection what Apple used to do up to 2015, and now they have brought it back, and that's really, really cool to have that back. Now, who this MacBook Pro is for, I would actually say this model is actually designed for probably more of those kind of students who are a little bit more further ahead in saying in the IT world, or they're actually studying IT, or let's say you are an amateur in your profession. So say you're an amateur photographer, or you know, if you're an amateur video creator, or let's say you're getting started with YouTube and you've got a bit further into it. Let's say you've got, say, 10,000, 20,000 subscribers, you're a bit further into your journey, you're not starting out with 100 subscribers, you're wanting a bit more further, then this MacBook Pro is perfect for you. It has the ability to easily chew its way through 4K video. If you were using the likes of Final Cut Pro and let's say Premiere or DaVinci, then yeah, there's going to be absolutely no problems with that as well. The same with Photoshop or Lightroom. This MacBook Pro can easily get through editing loads of different kind of clips and photos with no hassle whatsoever. Again, because this model starts with 16 gigabytes of RAM and goes all the way up to 64 gigabytes of RAM, basically you can open up multiple apps all at the same time, and this MacBook Pro does not break a sweat. Personally though, if I was saying, if you're buying this 14-inch MacBook Pro, you do have the ability, like I said earlier in this video, to choose from an M1 Pro all the way up to an M1 Max. I personally wouldn't favour going for an M1 Max inside this MacBook Pro unless you really need a larger screen, and we'll talk about that in a minute with the 16-inch MacBook Pro. I would personally say get an M1 Pro inside this, mainly because other YouTubers out there have shown that the thermals with having an M1 Max inside this get a little bit hotter compared to, say, the 16-inch MacBook Pro. There's a little bit more space for air to breathe around. And I'm not saying this is going to overheat or anything. It just makes more sense, really, just to have a bigger screen with that. But if you are desperate to get a smaller screen MacBook Pro and make it as powerful as you can, yeah, you can do this MacBook Pro, and there's nothing wrong with doing that. So yeah, do look into that. But personally, I would say generally, an M1 Pro is going to be more than enough for most people with kind of doing kind of amateur sort of things, doing things as a hobby, photography, videos, 3D files and things like this. And to be honest, you'll be future-proofed for many years, even with that chipset. For support with this MacBook Pro, it is most likely that, like the M1 chipset, it will probably get 5 to 6 years of support from Apple into the future. So if you do buy one of these, you've got the reassurance you're probably going to get that long of updates, at least on this MacBook Pro. Well, let's move then on to the big daddy, the 16-inch MacBook Pro. Now, basically, for design-wise, it is almost identical to the 14-inch MacBook Pro. So if you've just skipped over to the 16-inch MacBook Pro and not looked at the 14-inch, I'm going to basically go over some of the points, but not in much detail. You get that mini LED display, what's much more brighter than, say, the likes of the 13-inch MacBook Pro. You get all those additional ports that I talked about, the three USB-C ports, and then also the MagSafe, and also that SD card slot and that HDMI port. And also, at the same time, you get that brand new design, 16 2-point inch design, and you also get this notch at the top if you love it or you hate it. Now, who I'd say this MacBook Pro is for? I would say it's also for those people who I took the 14-inch MacBook Pros for. So those amateur photographers out there, or those people who are going into university or the college who are studying kind of Photoshop, video editing, photo editing, you get the idea. Definitely this model is for you guys, but if you can't afford it, get this model here. But what I would also say this MacBook Pro is for is definitely for those professionals and for example, those video creators who are making videos daily, or let's say they're making 3 or 4 videos a week. This MacBook Pro is absolutely perfect for you. With having the M1 Max equipped inside, say, the likes of this MacBook Pro, remember you can put that in the 14-inch as well, it could easily chew its way through 8K video. Now, as you may know out there, 8K video isn't really the standard yet, but it probably will be in the future. What makes this MacBook Pro, and also this MacBook Pro, future-proof for those reasons, if you're going to be editing, say, 8K video. Also, you have the ability to load loads of different kind of music streams into this MacBook Pro as well, and it can handle it with the amount of RAM and that M1 Max chipset inside it. Granted, you're going to have to get some dongles to plug into this MacBook Pro or dock for doing that, but there's lots of accessories out there. And like I said, do check out in my description the different sort of hubs and bits and pieces that you can buy for these MacBook Pros. And the great thing is they're all compatible with each other. Everything I'm putting in my accessories is not just exclusive to one machine, it works on all 3 of these MacBook Pros. Again, what I would say with this MacBook Pro, you can put an M1 Pro inside it, but personally, I would say put an M1 Max inside it because it has the potential and it has that breathing space with the fans inside it compared to, say, the 14-inch MacBook Pro. Like I say again, I'm not putting down the 14-inch MacBook Pro. I absolutely love it. But I just think it makes more sense to put that higher core kind of CPU into this model here, especially if you're going to be doing kind of those daily creating videos or editing photos in the likes of Lightroom, Photoshop, and whatever like that. It's probably better to have that kind of better, more fan potential and breathing space inside the 16-inch MacBook Pro. Now, for prices, as you can see here, they are quite expensive for MacBook Pros. The 13-inch MacBook Pro right now starts at around about $1,200 US or $1,300 US for the baseline model. The same with this 14-inch MacBook Pro here. It starts at $1,999 US, so basically $2,000, and that's for the M1 Pro with that 8-core and that 14-core GPU. And it can go right up beyond that into around about $5,000. And the same here with the 16-inch MacBook Pro. It starts at $2,499 US, and it can go right up beyond $6,000 for this machine if you put all the top storage in, top amount of RAM, top M1 Max chipset inside it. But don't go too crazy. Make sure that you pick basically the right GPU and CPU, RAM amount and storage amount for your needs. Remember, all of these machines are super capable, and remember, the best thing to do is not compare them to a standard Intel MacBook Pro. They're completely in a different ball game. So I know, for example, a lot of people have moaned that the M1 13-inch MacBook Pro only comes with 8 GB of RAM, and they're going, 8 GB of RAM in 2021? You must be nuts, and you call this a pro machine. But you know, like I said, check out some of my videos, check out lots of other people's videos on YouTube, you will see that 8 GB of RAM and the way how Apple Silicon handles that 8 GB of RAM is completely different to the way of, say, an AMD chipset or an Intel chipset would handle it. And basically, 8 GB of RAM is more than enough for most people, and even doing some video editing on 8 GB of RAM is absolutely fine, and it won't basically make your MacBook Pro overheat or blow up or anything like that. But you're getting the idea. There's some great options out there, and yeah, do choose wisely, but also at the same time, no matter what MacBook Pro that you do pick, you can't go wrong in your decision. Well guys, it's also time to wrap up this video, so if you have enjoyed watching it, please do press the like button, and also at the same time as well, if you want to hear the latest Apple news, reviews and comparisons, please also make sure that you hit that subscribe button followed by the notification bell. Until next time guys, I will see you really soon. Bye bye.